So Silent Spring created a whole new environment globally that created the basis for other people to take advantage of our fundamental desire to have compatibility and support to the environment and the natural habitats around us. We all want that, but people have taken advantage of that. Maurice Strong, by the way, I think he pronounces his name Morris. I've called him Maurice for years, but Morris Strong has been well documented in the presentations you've already seen today. He is central to this. This guy didn't even graduate from high school. He must truly be brilliant, because he went on to run his own oil companies, he went on to represent the Canadian government, and then he went on to become a mainstay in the environmental movement in the UN. As you already know, he headed up the UN environmental program, and he has been at the crux of pulling together the nations to get all of this environmental movement going, which led up in 1988 to the creation of the UN Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, the UNIPCC. This IPCC has been the focal point of the nations since 88, and every report that they issue every few years has been used as another tool to beat us up over the environment and climate and how mankind rules the climate, how the sun has no role, and how we need to change our lives to comply with what the UN says. We have other people, as shown on the chart, that you're well aware of. Al Gore, former VP, he produced a video, he got the Nobel Prize for doing all these great things, and all along the way, from the time he began this, he was telling us that global warming was ongoing and a continuous threat. If he had only asked the scientists who monitor global climate, he would have found out that when he made Inconvenient Truth, when he got his Nobel Prize and made $100,000 going around the world giving speaking engagements, the Earth was not warming at all. And yet, we have had to deal with him, deal with his after effects. President Obama, when he came in, was doing the same thing. In early 2007, when I first discovered these solar cycles that drive our climate, I made the announcement and notified the White House, Congress, all the mainstream media except CBS. There was no point talking to them. And I made it very clear to everyone I knew that we were about to enter a cold phase of 30 or 40 years of dangerous cold weather. President Obama was notified, all his key advisors were notified, John McCain was notified, every senator in the United States was notified, every attorney general was notified, every governor was notified, including here in Florida. There is no one in our major government structure that was not notified by me that this was coming. Now, how do you think I was received when I made this announcement?
Tarred and feathered.
Tarred and feathered, absolutely.
Working for the oil company.
You name it, every excuse in the world, I was, as Arthur Schopenhauer would tell you, ridiculed, slandered, whatever, by both political parties. Now, that's a curious statement. You would think conservatives would be a little more amenable. Not at that time, they weren't. Senator McCain and Senator Barack Obama were both running for president. They both knew it was a close election. They both wanted the green vote. And they both said global warming is a threat and we will fix it. I had Republicans call me and say, John, you got to stop talking this way. I had liberals and progressives call me, and I can't tell you on air what they said. But it was typical of what we've already heard. No one was attacking the science, but they felt free to attack me personally. So if you go to the internet, you're going to see a lot of people from back in 07 and 08 who said some terrible things about me and my scientists and my research. It's still on the web. Once you get something on the web, it doesn't disappear. It may go down to a lower search category, but someone will bring it back up, and then it gets reintegrated back into the system. The problem is that we have been misled all along, and that this has been a concerted, massive effort by a socialist progressive group globally to take control of our lives and force us to live by their standards. And we're going to get into some of those detailed standards. You've heard some already. Dr. Kaufman's presentation earlier gave some pretty shocking stuff. Wait till you hear the details of their latest plan, the Great Green Technology Transformation. We'll talk about that later. Morris Strong, we've already talked about him. He actually believes that collapse of the global industrial society is what we need. Collapse of the industrial society that has lengthened the lifespan of people, that has saved lives, that has given us a future of great promise, and he wants to eradicate that. This is coming from a guy who got his start in the oil patch. But he's disavowed all that. And when he was accused of taking $989,000 as a kickback during the oil for food scam operated by Saddam Hussein, and he endorsed the check, by the way, made out to him, he endorsed it. Of course, he denied having any involvement. He left the UN at that point, rightfully so. Tim Wirth, Richard Benedict, these are just part of the crowd. We're going to talk about a few more names, but there have been many people in our government who have also made it very clear the climate change and the environmental movement are simply tools for them to impose what they want on our society, and it doesn't have to be correct. There has not been a requirement for scientific evidence to back up global warming. Because once it became policy at the UN, once it's policy, you don't need to justify it anymore. How many times have we heard from Al Gore, the science is settled? It was never settled because it was never debated. And all of those good scientists who became part of the IPCC conferences and reports that really saw this and tried to resign, they kept their names on the reports. When they had to sue the UN to get their names off the reports, they still didn't do it. It's incredible how these reports got put together. We could spend hours going through each one of them. I won't do that today, but let me tell you, I have, and they are full of lies, distortions, and bad science, which I may call BS from time to time. And that's what I mean, bad science. Al Gore, of course, we've talked about many times. But Al Gore also had made a statement previously that he thought it was okay to exaggerate to get the attention of the media so that he could sell his story. Alan Karuba, one of the great internet commentators, brilliant man, has analyzed Gore's history, and he said, you know, the problem we have with Gore is that he's motivated by power, money, and fame. He's not motivated by the good things he talks about. Look at what he's really doing. And you'll find out we've got a different Al Gore. And according to Alan Karuba, this is a global fraud. And if you read my book, you'll see I make no bones about it. Man-made global warming, as espoused by this current administration and the United States and the United Nations, is the greatest scientific fraud in the history of science. Simple. No questions, that's the way it is. If you read the book, if you go to the website and look at all the press releases, you'll see all of the comments from other scientists that have been saying the same thing. There's a grand myth that Al and company put out, which is that there are thousands of scientists who say global warming's real. Not so. If you go back to the original UN documents, they said there are 3,000, 4,000 scientists that contributed to this. We've tried to find the actual list and the names. The UN won't disclose them, but we did find through other means that it's probably only 20%. Maybe 600 or 800 are actually practicing climate scientists and environmental scientists of any credentials that have been contributing to this report. Not 3,000, not 4,000, only 20% of that. On the other hand, if you go to the OISM.org website, you'll see 32,000 scientists that says global warming is not man-made. It is just the opposite of what we've been told. Democrat Walter Russell Mead attacks Al Gore. Now, why would a Democrat do that? Well, I've actually looked into Walter Russell Mead Correct. Sorry about that. He's a Democrat, but he's actually an independent in my view of his voting record. But nonetheless, he's come out and he said, listen, if you follow people like Al Gore, you have to be aware of something. What they say and what they do are two totally different things. Al Gore has mansions and homes around the world paying huge electrical bills. Al Gore has a private jet who, according to Al Meade, or Walter Meade, says you can't be flying around the world complaining about poor people in India and China having a carbon footprint when your one plane flight can consume more carbon than they can in their lifetime. He said, the problem with Al Gore is he doesn't live up to his own preaching. He's just the opposite of his own preaching. As it turns out, Al Gore and Walter Meade are both wrong. Carbon dioxide, the crux of the global warming theory, is so insignificant a gas and has so little impact on our climate that neither of them are correct about their conclusions about its role in climate. Here are some others. The late Stephen Snyder out of Stanford, well known for talking about global warming and its horrible effects it will have on everyone. But if you look at that, you'll see that he also acknowledges sometimes you got to scare people, tell them things that maybe you don't have the science for, and that's the way you'll get the media to pay attention to you. I think we ought to tell the truth. Do you think we ought to tell the truth?
Yeah.
I'm not Dutch, but I think his name is Ivo de Boer, if anyone can correct me on that. Number two man at the helm behind Dr. Pachauri at the UN. Yves de Boer made it very clear. He wanted to make everyone a criminal if you did not go along with the UN IPCC reports. And it gets worse, much worse. James Hansen at NASA has been the poster boy of government speak on global warming caused by man. But he has gone off the deep end, like I think Al Gore recently did on Met. He's calling coal companies, coal producers, death merchants, and coal trains, death trains. This guy has really gone way beyond being a NASA scientist and did so years ago.
But,
yes. So what is the truth? Well, actually there are many truths. It would take me a long time to tell you about them. I've outlined some of them here, but let's talk a little about them. If you go back to the UN reports, they say, well, the sun is not a big player in climate. Now, anyone with half a sense knows that's not true at the outset. But they show through science, supposed science, what I call...
BS.
BS. Let's hear that again.
BS.
Thank you. What is really at the core of their justification, they say the sun varies too little to be the cause of the rapid cold and warm cycles we've had over thousands of years. In fact, if you go back and you look at the sun's variance in total solar irradiance, as it's called, you will find that only the slightest change in the sun's TSI has a very big impact on the Earth's climate. It is almost one-to-one correlated with climate changes on Earth. It is not minuscule, it is primary. And that's the core of my research. We'll get into that a little. The sun cycles that we have done research on have shown very clearly that if you just follow the sun, you'll know what's happening with our climate. And you'll know what's happening in the future. Today we're going to talk about nothing less than your future, as determined by the sun and the sun's repeating cycles. We're going to talk a little about what happened in the past and what it's going to happen in the future. There are scientists today, as of last week even, that are now still standing up and saying, no one can predict the climate. I will tell you here and now, that is wrong. I have done it. It works. Follow the sun and it will tell you the truth. Any questions on that? Okay.